Hello, everybody. You can hear me well, right? Yeah. So we're gonna start another full flight, and this time we're gonna be flying from Miami International here, Miami International to Newark International. And yeah, that's pretty much it. We're gonna be flying the United 777, and total flight time is about 3 hours. So that's exciting, and Right now, the 777 is in the cold and dark state, so we're gonna start it up, and we'll hopefully get in the air as soon as possible. So yeah, so let's start it up. Alright, so the GPU is connected, so we have ground power right now. That doesn't turn on. Alright, so systems are booting up right now. It takes some time. So the attitude indicator over here just turned on, and now we're just going to wait for the screen to turn on. You see the GPU connected, GPU air conditioning. Screens came on. Alright, so let's start our setup now. So, yeah, you can come on. If you start. Started. Hydraulics. And go down. So the center checklists are actually in order, thank God. See the air bridge connected. It's very cool. So we can set the FMC right now. Let me set the parking brake. And we're not flying on Batum right now because Miami isn't really online. Maybe we'll fly or disregard. So yeah, we're not gonna fly on Batum. Pretty sad. I will fly in across the pond. Yeah, that'll be exciting. I'm actually gonna push the full flight, so full 8 or 7 hours. So Miami's a origin, and Newark is a destination. K E W. Flight number is United, United something, United 2288. The real flight, the real United 28 from Miami to from Miami to Newark. The flight was canceled because of the COVID-19 outbreak. But that's okay. Alright, so departure runway is 09er. I'm actually very unfamiliar with the Miami layout of the airport. So departure. So Miami departure. It'll be the Valley departure. So let's see if we can find that. It's right here. To the valley, and after that it's direct to permit, which is a waypoint after valley. P-E-R-M-I-T. Permit. And valley entry. I spelled that wrong, Permit. There we go. And AR6, AR16, something. Alfa Romeo 16, and ILM. It looked like LIM, it's actually ILM. Then J109. And then after that, it's our arrival into Nova. So we'll be doing landing on 04 left. So I have 04 left. And this departure, this arrival. Let's look at the flight. I'm still getting used to using a chase plane. I just installed it recently. Discount energy somewhere. That's better. Alright, there we go. So that would be our approach. C04 left is right there. Very, very nice. Alright, I think it's time for our pre-flight checklist finally. So, button break is set, battery switch is on, if you started, smoking signs and passenger signs are on, cabin utility is on, ADRU is on, FMC menu, we haven't set everything in the FMC, right? Let's do that quickly. Alright, so 028, going in reserves, reserve for this flight would be, 2.8, so you can do 3, you can do 2.8. And cruising altitude will be flight level 2900. We can change it to 300. Cost index 200. Or 220. Alright, that's it. So takeoff plus 15 we'll be using. CG thrust. Here. speed is only 77 knots. And the yaw speed is 168 knots. VT speed is only 83 knots. So I set this efficiency to the takeoff performance and this to the route legs. So yeah, now we can continue LO. LO is a lot of pilot. Hopefully. Alright, so continuing with the checklist, left and right both tie switches. Left and right bus tie switches are auto. Left and right generator control switch switches. Are on. Backup switches are on. They will be, right? Yeah. Nav lights are on, beacon lights are on, emergency lights are on, left and right packs are on, right? Yes. FMC is set, transponder is on, my transponder is on. FMC is set, takeoff briefing is completed. Alright, so we can move on to the output preparation checklist. Before we do that, we need to set our payload and then our fuel weight in this FMC. So FS actions and fuel. That we'll be carrying with us 26,000 pounds of fuel. Since right now we have 32. So we'll do 35,000 pounds of fuel. And our payload is. Oh, it's already set. Yeah, everything's already set. Okay then. Let's close the door. Disconnect the jetway. There we go. Gas is set. Alright, let's get on the road. Well, not really, let's get in the sky. Alright, so park brake is set in the heat. Yeah, we're gonna need a little bit of heat, apparently. Primary left and right engine hydraulic pumps. Are on. Primary sensor 1 and sensor 2, engine hydraulic pumps, just electric hydraulic pumps are on. Electric light switches are on. ESR selectors. Oh, it's up here. Normal. Engineer view bleed there. Are on. Pressurization panel is set ATIS. We can have ATIS, so we can just save. Alright, so FMC is fully programmed, autopilot is set, flight director is on, auto throttle is armed, LNV nav. Oh, what the hell is that? Oh, right. I haven't even activated the route. Okay, I'm selling the insulation fuel. is good hearing. Great, so we have an FQ. That's good to know. So, LM and VNAV are set. LM and VNAV are on. Audio break is set to RTO. Communication panels are checked. Mic check is checked. Alright, so, we have the before start checklist. So, doors are closed and locked. Parking brake is set. Shocks. Shocks. Shocks are removed. APU is fully running. Let me just check that again. Yep, APU is running. So shocks are removed. Right electric domain handle, hydraulic pumps are auto. Yeah, I just turned them all on. Passenger signs are on, beacon light is on, nav light is on, our brake is RTO. So push back. Push back and start. So start it in here. Menu, FS actions, push back, and I actually need to pull up the chart for landing. Let's just check what. I'll just use the navigation display. And we're going to be able to push back to the right. Usually ATC will tell you which way to push back. Right now we're
And
offline.
ground cockpit. Hi, Captain. We're all set to go up here. We've been cleared to push and start at your discretion.
Roger that, ready for push. Power and air clear, doors closed. We are ready for push back. Please park and brake, please.
Okay, parking brake is off, clear to push.
Launch engine start.
Brakes off, here we go.
This is why I really like the Electric 777. It has its own pushback features. Some add-on aircraft don't really have that. So I have to use this default shift P like the Airbus X. That doesn't have a pushback feature. Sad. Alright, so right engine, come on right now. Right engine start. Guy's not even driving in the road. None of them are. And they almost crashed into us. Alright, so right engine is started. Right and left are both running. You can see here.
Pressure's normal.
Okay, sir. Tow bar is on. Fin is out. Watch the fin on the right.
Alright, guys. Thanks. You're cleared to disconnect. We will be watching for the pin and the release from guidance on the right side of the airplane. And we'll see you guys next time through.
Roger that. Have a good flight.
Alright, so I'm just looking through the charts, my charts, checking our departure. Can't seem to find the departures. That's okay though. Sorry about this, guys. I'm just trying to find the charts for our departure. Alright, here we go, I found our departure chart. Alright, so let's just start taxiing then. Let's just start taxiing randomly, trying to find our way. Skip all of those flight checks. Alright, so let's check our alarms. Good. Full left and elevator. Full up. Full down. And the rear, as we tested with the taxiing all of a sudden, it works. North runway 09. Zero nine is the far one. Up to the south. So we are taxiing in November. Alright, let me find out quickly. Alright, so November, and maybe you can turn up Mike. Right now we're at Juliet. So we'll go to Zulu, and from Zulu we'll go on Quebec and to across in the 30. Yeah, we'll continue to Zulu until then. Continue to travel the runway. Yes, I'm very, very, very much unfamiliar with Miami International Airport. I've never been here in real life. I've never been to Miami. I've been to Florida, but I've never been to Miami specifically. Right here, Zulu. still on Zulu. I'm gonna cross, no, we're not gonna cross this runway. Just that'll lead us to the cargo section, and I don't wanna go there. Alright, so we'll turn on, Quebec to Victor. Then we'll find our way to 09 on our left. So let's turn left here. It's 6 a.m. and still dark outside. And everybody's still asleep. The opposite way. Okay, we need to turn here. Wait, no, not. No, we're not going the opposite way. Yeah, we're good. Okay. Hello, we're good. Stop stopping. Keep me moving. I hate them. You just stop in the middle of the taxiway. Taxi. This is why I need ATC. This is why ATC should be online most times. So we are on taxiway Quebec. We'll turn on taxiways here. So that's us. So that one to our right is Victor. Victor, we are in Quebec. And we'll turn on Sierra. And she stopped stopping. Keep moving. Oh, no. And it stopped again. There we go. This is Victor again. We are on. Quebec. So there's a term. Over there. So you have to turn on Sierra. Which this is uniform. So next one will be Sierra. Cross the runway over here. For some reason, the taxis, the taxi lines aren't showing up. That's okay though. You can kind of see the silhouette of them. I know. Sorry, it's a very, very long taxi. Speed's probably going to be longer than it should be.
Approaching 3-0.
So a taxi all the way. Taxi all the way from Sierra. Because Sierra goes all the way to the beginning of runway 09. And taxis, the taxi lines, yellow lines come back. don't know where they went. That's okay though. That guy's really fast. That guy. Apart from Amsterdam and that room, I guess I'll put them to the far left. This is probably one of my longest taxis ever. I'm gonna stop recording there because there's no, literally no point in recording this. So yeah, I'll see you when we hold short of the river. So yeah. Alright, so just approaching the boarding point for zero matter. So, tax, that's okay. Alright, so holding point is reached. The bottom brake is set. So before takeoff checklist. The holding point is reached. Park brake is set. Flaps are set. Cabin lights are auto. Data beta is checked. Nav equipment is checked. Lane lights are on. Strip lights are on. The transponder's TAR and TKS is checked. Clock is the starter clock. So, starter clock set. So, yeah, so let's just start taxiing down to the runway. And let's get ready for takeoff. Yeah, it's just very early. Yes, I know. Why would I look up this early? On a Saturday. Who does that? And while you're quarantined. Cabinet's ready. You're good ass. Wait for that. We want to take off with the flight attendants from where we're roaming around. My next flight after this has been with the quality wings. 87, and I like the quality wings because you can actually hear the...
09.
Can actually hear the in-flight service, like the in-flight announcement, the passenger briefing, which I really love to hear. It's really cool. I don't know if it has a pushback feature, but I really hope it does. And if it has a pushback feature, then it would probably be my favorite aircraft. Because I like the 787 in general. I say it's a cool airplane.
On runway 09.
All right, so I think everything's set. So let's bump it up a notch. So throttle is halfway. Airspeed is alive. Cool. Really laggy. Set. We want to rotate. Alright, possibly the right gear is up. Autopilot is set. Flaps 5. Flaps 5 is set. Flaps 5 is set. Flaps 1. Flaps 1 is set. Miami, Florida. Very, very nice, very sunny. Alright, flaps 0. Flaps up. Transition altitude is 18,000 feet for this departure. have checklists. Here's a auto brake is off. Taxi lights are off. Runway turn lights are off. Headlight is auto. Climb-out checklist. Autopilot is on. Oh, that we never set. Altimeter sets standard. That's after the transit, too, which is 18,000 feet, so we still have time. So, passenger signs, landing lights are off. We turn the passenger signs off after we reach air transition altitude of 18,000 feet. So because of this long taxi and it's making the video longer, If it wait until we reach 18,000 feet even, this video will be pretty, pretty long. So, I'm gonna stop recording right now. I'll stop the recording at this speed. And, I will start it again once we reach our descent into Newark, New Jersey. So yeah, I will see you then. Bye bye! Welcome back. So it's 8:24 p.m. We're gonna be landing at Newark around 9 a.m. Sorry, it's 8:24 a.m. And yeah, so the airport is somewhere over here. You can see in our PFD, you can see the student runway right there. We might actually have to do some delay vectors, but yeah, because we're kind of high right now. We're not descending any faster. I'm just gonna put out the speed brakes for a second. So the network is somewhere up there at. You know what, we'll do delay vectors, it's okay. Let's bring this out over here. So we'll do delay vectors until we reach 3,000 feet, and then we'll... 2,800 feet. And then we'll get back on track on the approach to Newark. Alright, so, my checklist is completed, and we're doing the separation checklist. It's also completed. So, our next checklist is the approach checklist, which we still have time, actually. Let's arm the speed brake. Speed brakes are armed. airspeed is 154 knots. So the airspeed is 154 knots. But actually, the rev speed is 136 knots. Pretty low speed. I think I'll set flaps one once we get lined up again. Actually, let's do flaps one right now. So flaps one is set. Cabin is ready. Cabin is ready. That looks good. Landing on one. Is that the runway over there? Really? Interesting. Flaps 15. Flaps 20. Gear down. Alright, so we're lined up with the local localizer. Approach checklist. Looking there is check localizer frequency is check which is armed. Last level by flaps apex. Flaps are not set currently, so let's set flaps 30. Alright, flaps are set 30. Gear is down, and we are ready to land.
2500.
The airport is loading in right now, so that's good. Autopilot, autopilot is disconnected, sorry. So I'm hand flying the aircraft right now.
Light slope. 50. 30. 10.
All right, touchdown. Really, really often this airline there, sorry about that. Alright, so autopilot disconnect. Land as well. Runway turnoffs. And taxi lights. If you start. is coming on. Welcome to the network, everybody. Welcome to the network. So yeah, this is a big scenery package. So that's why there was like stuttering. That's why there was stuttering and there was like a huge slideshow one time. Sorry about that, guys. Alright, we're actually a little bit ahead of time. So let's park at this gate over here. Parking brake is set. If he's running, right? So, left engine come off. Right engine turn. Come off. Flaps come off. Brakes. Doors will open. Speed brakes are off. Flight director, both are off. GPU connected. GPU connected. FSX actions. Ground connections. The GPU is connected. So hydraulics, I mean, sorry. GPU is connected, yeah, there. So ground power is on. That's APU muff. I can see why it's muff. Lights. So, we'll turn off these. Those lights can come off. What else? We'll do the parking shutdown check. What's that? If you're ready. Alright, so, parking shutdown check. Let's parking brake is set. Engine fuel control levers are cut off. Ground contacts is established. Well, not really. Passenger signs are they're still on, but I'm gonna turn them off. Beacon light is off. Everything is good. So, left and right back control switches are off. Fuel lever, fuel pumps are off, sorry. Hydraulics. These can come off. Fuel generator can come off, bus ties. ADR can come off. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, so thank you for watching. And yeah, this was a pretty short flight, only for 4 hours. Well, I mean, it's still kind of long, but it's pretty short in general. And I also included some cinematic shots of our flight, just because. Yeah, we included some cinematic shots. Well, I included some cinematic shots. Because I recently got Chase Plane, which is an, I think it's an Orbix product, I'm not sure. And, Chase Plane is pretty good. That's actually pretty much it. You can follow me on Instagram. Instagram is literally my YouTube channel name. It's the same thing, Sam PCAD. And, so you'll expect another flight. My next flight will be, will be my first flight to Eastern Asian country. I'll be flying to Japan because I also recently got scenery for Japan, Narita, Japan, that international airport, and Singapore International Airport. Yeah. Yeah, my goal is I really want to fly between Asia a lot, because that's like the only place that I don't really fly usually. I mainly just fly out of Europe. Yeah, because I have a lot of, because there are a lot of airports in Europe and stuff. Yeah, I know it wouldn't really be senseless to fly in and out of Asia at these times because of the coronavirus outbreak. But, like, there's no other time than now, really, because, like, I just got the scenery. And, yeah, Chase Plane is a really good product, you should definitely buy it. I'm not really, like, supporting Chase Plane as, like, a sponsor, sort of, because I only have a few subscribers. Okay, bye-bye, I will see you later.